Hello, I'm Noreen Burke, professional organizer and craft lover. If you're a crafter, you know that we always have those teeny tiny things that are flat. Whether we make junk journals, card making, scrapbooking, decoupage, we seem to have all of these cute little flat things. The question is how to organize them. That's what we're going to cover today. I had gone to the store to buy some pockets. I know these are available and they're not very expensive, except that like just this little set for the baseball cards, which has all of these wonderful little tiny pockets inside. I didn't need a 10 pack. I needed one or two pages. So now I have all of this excess and this was $7. I also found that they had quad sheets, which would be great, except once again, I only needed one or two sheets. The rest were going to be wasted, and that's $7 or $8. So it came to me, Noreen, you used to do something like this when you were scrapbooking. I would make these custom pockets for embellishments to go inside or souvenirs when I would scrapbook. And that way I could still pull them out. They would be interactive. Or sometimes I would want a multi-page that would flip open. And I went, ah! I remembered what I used to do, and this will be the perfect solution for all of those little flat supplies you have. Let's get started. So no video from me would be complete without suggesting sort first. You need to know what you have and how you want it categorized before you can start creating the storage space for it. So here I'm going through the dies that I'm giving away. And by the way, you guys had a crazy amount of response to this. So I'm trying to make a little bit more of the die cut pack. So there'll be a couple less things in it, but they'll still be really nice sets and I think you'll enjoy them. So thank you so much for your overwhelming response to that. It was very exciting. So as I was going through these as an example, the first thing I did was break things down by color. Then I started separating the alphabets from the numbers, then small journal cards, large journal cards, and this gave me a very nice overall idea of what I had and how I would be using them. Now, a quick tip, when you're organizing your supplies, no matter what it is, I don't want you to approach it of where you use it. For example, when I first set up my crafting space, I had a section for painting, for scrapbooking. I had my office, and then I had just an area where I did miscellaneous crafts. And I had glue in each different space. That's logical, right? Except that sometimes I would want my double-sided tape that was on a roll. Well, that was over in my scrapbooking area. And sometimes I would want my E6000. Well, that was in my miscellaneous crafting area. So as I'm crafting, I would have to stop and go searching for, okay, where did I have that type of glue? Have them organized by what and how you use them. So if you're in the middle of a craft project and you need your glues, all of your glues should be together in one place and you go to that spot to get your supplies. This works for tools, pens, markers, any type of crafting you're doing, threads. If you have them organized in one place, you'll always know where to find them. So the last thing I'm adding in here are these cute little frames. But now that I'm all done sorting and I know what I want to do with these, it's time to bring out my sheet protector. This is a plain sheet protector. This is the one time I recommend not getting them from the Dollar Tree. Go ahead and spend a couple of extra dollars at Walmart or your local office supply and get something that's a little bit heavier duty. Now, I know I said the quads were silly, but I am going to start with this just because it's the easiest way to demonstrate for you. So I'm laying out what will fit in the sheet protector. And since these are quarters, I got a piece of paper and folded it in fourths so that I would have a template as I'm cutting and creating the seams for this. So the first thing I'm going to do is double check that everything will fit into my little quads. And then I'm going to make a seam that I can cut so that I start creating those individual pockets. I only want to cut the top portion of the sheet protector, so make sure that your holes are on the correct side and you're cutting into the top of the sheet protector. So I'm going to pinch just the top layer of the sheet protector and make the teeniest, tiniest cut. Then we have a place to slip the scissors in, and I'm just going to use that folded paper as a guideline to cut all the way across so that I have a second opening in this sheet protector. And this guideline allowed me to make sure that it was straight. Now here's the exciting part of this project. I am taking my everyday normal iron and I turned it to between the medium and high heat. I'm using my ruler as a guideline and I'm taking just the edge of my iron and creating a seam underneath my ruler. So watch, I'm just gonna drag it across and it's fusing the sheet protector together. And now I have a pocket on the top and whatever I put in here will not slide through to the bottom. It is that easy. Look at this. I put it inside and now I have a place and I still have an opening cut underneath to put something in that bottom pocket. Now I'm going to show you how to make the seam that goes vertically. So once again, I'm making sure that my openings are facing up. I'm taking my ruler again, and whether you're right or left-handed, you're going to want to make sure that where you're running the seam, it is still even. So I'm making sure the iron is away from me so I don't burn myself. I'm holding the ruler firmly down so that it doesn't move. It's my perfect guideline, and it's done. You guys, I used to use this all of the time with scrapbooking. I now have 4 easy little pockets to get into. But if I wanted to make 6 pockets, I could just cut the sheet protector in different places so that I have more openings. And as long as I always run the seam that I'm sealing above the cut part, I'll always have easy access to these. And look at how easy it slides in. I can't wait to see what you guys are able to do. Think of organizing your flat flowers, your die cuts, your actual die cut pieces. And once you're done creating the custom space, you can just get out a 3-ring binder and you can have a binder for each major category that you have. And you can even use tabs inside of the binders to really break down the categories of these and have them neatly on a shelf. I'm so excited about this. I really think that this is going to be so helpful for you in your craft room. Imagine I pull out my book and it says die cuts, and then inside I have tabs dividing the journal spots, the alphabets, the photo squares. How easy would it be to find the things you need and just have it taking up a tiny footprint on your shelf? And you could use both sides of it. You just have to reach inside the little pocket, pull it out, and you're ready to go. How often would you think of an iron making such amazing customized storage for you? I am really excited about this one because it is so economical. I think you can get a pack of the heavy-duty sheet protectors for about $5 from Walmart, and I think you can even get bigger packs if you have a lot of these types of embellishments that you want to organize online at Amazon. The most expensive pack I saw was $10, and it came with 100 pages. So that is pennies per page. And once you lay out what your supplies are and you have that overall idea of categories, it takes minutes to go ahead and plan out the exact pocket sizes you need, make those little slices, and then use your iron to seal up the seams so you have those pockets. If you've been watching for a little while or you ever notice in the background, I am a huge Mary Englebright fan, and I wanted to share something that I got in the mail yesterday. Laura sent this to me, and I couldn't have been more excited and more appreciative. Laura, thank you so very much. I love the book. I've already gone through it a couple of times, so have my daughters. It's absolutely beautiful. I've always been really inspired by Mary Englebright. Her little whimsical drawings and sayings have always just been so enjoyed by me. So Laura, thank you. Laura also happens to be one of my Patreons, which is the perfect segue. I do have a new few Patreons, so I wanted to say thank you to them. The reason I set up a Patreon is because I really like doing the virtual organizing. Their support allows me to do viewer makeovers at no charge, which is such a lovely gift for not only me, but for people out there. But the other reason I have the Patreon is I am hoping someday to have a budget to get an RV, so that I could start driving around the US and helping you at home get organized. So if you're interested in doing that, My information for Patreon is in the link below, but my new Patreons join this list of lovely supporters who I cannot be grateful enough to. Thank you so much for watching today's video, and I will see you in just a couple days. Bye!